52nd Thessalonica Film Festival was held as Greece was hitting the headlines because of the country's debt crisis and turmoil in the government. Stringent economies affected the festival, but in spite of heavy budget cuts, it staged a rich and eclectic program, screening 150 feature films and documentaries from 53 countries during 10 days. 15 films were up for prizes in the main section of the festival. It is Dimitri Epide's second festival as director. He took over at the helm 2 years ago and inherited several million euros of debt. Hollywood stars were regular visitors to previous festivals. This year, the director focused on what he believes to be the essential elements of the festival.
I believe the stars are the films on the screen, and I'm a purist in my choices. I think good cinema matters. We don't need Hollywood to be circulating here at a huge cost. I want these young people that frequent the theaters to come out inspired, knowing that we're not up on a different kind of star, far away from the Earth, but we're a part of this Earth, a part of this small planet.
And you're going to live with it for...
The Russian film Twilight Portrait, a dark tale by Angelina Nikonova of Russian society's violent side, scooped the prize for best feature film at the festival.
Twilight Portrait.
The film is a complex psychological portrait of a social worker played by Olga Divinichinaya, who also co-wrote the screenplay. She falls in love with one of the policemen who raped her. As well as winning the Golden Alexander Prize, which comes with a 20,000 euro check, Twilight Portrait also took the Greek Film Critics Prize. Angelina Nikonova studied in New York City, and this is her first feature film.
In which way you work with actors? In which way you oppose your will, your artistic vision?
Working with me is on one hand easy, and on the other hand not so easy. Based on the screenplay, I let the actors improvise, but in the end, it's me who takes the final decision on how we will progress. The Silver Alexander Special Jury Award, which comes with 10,000 euros, went to a Czech production directed by Václav Kadrenka. 80 Letters is about a teenager and his mother who want to leave the communist country of Czechoslovakia in 1987 to join his father who lives in the UK. The film follows their continuing battle with communist bureaucracy and the monotonous waiting. The story is based on the director's own past, and his shooting style was influenced by Romanian New Wave films.
I decided to tell the story in a different kind of style, you know. It's not an analytical or psychological film. It's more a movie about a loss, about absence of the father, and about the perspective and observation of a young boy.
Judges awarded the third prize, the Bronze Alexander for originality and innovation, to Porfirio, a co-production by Colombia, Spain, Uruguay, France and Argentina, directed by Alejandro Landes. The movie, a mix of documentary and fiction, tells the story of Porfirio, who is paralyzed from the waist down after being accidentally shot by a policeman in 1991. After waiting for more than a decade for financial compensation from the government, which he never receives, he tries unsuccessfully in 2005 to hijack an aeroplane by hiding grenades in his diapers.
I read the note in a newspaper. And, you read all these sorts of crazy, extraordinary, or sometimes very violent stories in the newspaper, and you throw them out with breakfast. But this stayed with me, and 3 months later, I knocked on the door of the man everyone had labeled the air pirate, the plane hijacker.
These are all the winners of the 52nd Thessalonica Film Festival. At this international film festival, the cinemas were packed, in spite of the Greek crisis. Around 80,000 tickets were sold, about 20% more than last year, so the festival organisers should be satisfied.
Wolfgang Spindler aus Thessaloniki für euronews.